Hello and welcome! I'm Grafana Champion and co-founder of Volkov Labs. On this channel, we explore non-conventional ways of using Grafana, where Grafana goes far beyond observability with the help of tools such as a business suite plugin collection. We provide you with tutorials and examples that are easy to follow. Almost every video accompanies a blog post allowing you to take code snippets and read material at your own pace. In this video, I will guide you through creating a business dashboard and explain all the basic concepts of Grafana dashboard creation. Are you ready? Let's go! This is the Grafana dashboard I'm going to create in this video. It consists of 8 visualization panels. Some are business charts and some are time series. I also have a stat panel and business calendar panel. On a separate dashboard, I have the business forms panel, where a user enters required data elements for a new release and submits them into the data source, timescale in my example. For convenience, all entered elements are displayed right away here using the business table panel. Before examining the visualization panel configurations, let's quickly review the data flow. So there are 3 sources of data for our release dashboard: Grafana.com, GitHub.com, and the user entry on the business forms panel on the Grafana dashboard. We run the cron script hourly to read from Grafana and GitHub respectively. All fetched data is captured in the timescale database in 3 tables. Grafana, here I have plugin name, timestamps, and the number of downloads. GitHub table, plugin name, timestamps, and the number of open issues. And the release table with the plugin name, date of the release, date of the next anticipated release, unique plugin identifier, and the release features description in the HTML format, so it appears nicely on the Grafana dashboard later. For any visualization panel in Grafana, I'm going to have the following to configure: a data source parameter, where the data for your visualization is coming from. The choices are, first, the most obvious are the pre-installed and pre-configured data source plugins. I have timescale and some other ones in this list. They usually have colorful icons and no special symbols in the name. If you need help installing a plugin on OSS Enterprise Grafana or your cloud account, please refer to this video or the accompanying blog post. Link to both I will place in the description box down below. In addition to listing of pre-installed and pre-configured data sources plugins, I have these 3 with special characters at the beginning and at the ending of their names. Grafana is to get some experimental data. It is a great choice when you are just learning Grafana and need some dummy inputs for your visualizations. However, the limitations of this data source is that it provides only these 3 possibilities of your dummy data frame. If you need a specific data frame, use our business input data source. With that, you can create any data frame of any structure with any data type. And you even can utilize Grafana LLM app to connect to OpenAI and use the English language to request data, something like please return JSON data with 2 arrays, data frame, and price of a Bitcoin. Links to the business input data source materials are in the description box down below. The next special data source is dashboard. It is when you want to reuse the other data source from the same dashboard. It is excellent for performance since the query runs only once and the fetched data can be reused multiple times. With the dashboard data source, I need to specify which panel I want to take the data from. And the last option among the special data sources is mixed. It is when you need to combine multiple data sources for one panel. When I select mixed, this dropdown appears next to the query name. When I add another query, I can specify a different data source and therefore have a specific data source for each query. Let's move to the next parameter. After the data source is specified, I need to enter one or multiple queries. In my example, the first query, A, returns all our plugin names with the latest available plugin version and the number of days since the newest release. Query B returns the exact plugin names listing with the days until the next anticipated release. After the queries are specified, starting from Grafana 11.3, you can go into the query inspection and here on the data tab, review the returned data frames. I have 2 data frames and here I can switch between them. The next step is to set up one or multiple transformations. It is an optional step, but could be a life saver. Every visualization panel expects data in a specific format. Before you use a visualization panel, it is good to learn what format is expected. If and when the expected format differs from what your data source returns, transformations help find the common denominator. For instance, my business charts bar visualization panel needs one data frame with three columns, one with the labels, plugin names, and two numerical numbers. But as you can see, I have two data frames instead. To solve that, I go to the Transformations tab, select the Join by Field transformation, mode inner using the title field. Now, if I go back into the Query Inspector Data tab, switch this Apply Panel transformation, I see one data frame with two columns, exactly what my visualization panel requires. More information about Grafana transformations is here in our Grafana Crash Course, link in the description box down below. After the data frame is in appropriate shape, select the visualization panel type. Every panel has two types of parameters to configure: common, which are part of core Grafana and are mainly shareable between all Grafana visualization panels, and specific to this panel. Now I will go into each panel edit mode to break down the configuration. First, the lifecycle panel. I will open it in the view mode to see better. It shows our products, 10 open source business suite plugins, business intelligence, and the environment data source. For each, you can see the number of days since the last release and how long it will be until the next planned release. We aim to have a new release every 100 days for each plugin, and so far have been successful with that goal. Now let's open this panel in the edit mode. Data source timescale. I already showed that here I have two queries, A and B, and then I combine them using the join by field transformation. Here is the final data frame with three columns. For the visualization panel configuration edit mode, I will use the code because I know how to transfer the data from the data frames into the charts function, basically to here. The alternative is to use Visual Editor. The main difference is that with Visual Editor, you can skip the programming of the data transfer. It will be done for you. I posted a detailed video, this one, demonstrating how to work with our Visual Editor. And here, the official business charts documentation contains similar information. It should be enough to get you started with the Visual Editor if you prefer this method. Now let's take a look at the Grafana Toolkit visualization. The chart splits our 12 products into categories by supported Grafana version. We migrate to the latest version promptly. So at this moment, now 9 plugins support Grafana 11.3 and the rest 11.2. I connect to the timescale data source and specify a query where I list the Grafana version for each plugin. Then on the transformation tab, I use the grow by transformation where I select grow by, calculate, and total. This transformation is an analog for the SQL group by, and instead of using it, I could have rewrite MySQL and it would return the identical results. Alright, with this transformation, I have a list of all supported versions and the number of plugins in each category. This data frame format is what the business chart pie visualization expects. Moving to the business calendar visualization. It shows when releases are available for installation in the calendar format. With the agenda layout, you can see all releases listed one after the other. With those controls, you can switch months. In the edit mode, the configuration is very straightforward. Connect to the data source. The query is to select all required data elements from the release table, then select business calendar panel configuration on the right. In the data category, map the data frame columns with the panel fields. The next three visualizations, weekly downloads, total downloads, and total downloads by plugins, all use the Grafana table. These two are Grafana time series, and that one is a Grafana stat visualization. The queries are very similar. I extract the timestamp and then the plugin downloads. I use the organize fields by name transformation to convert the column names into user-friendly titles. Here I can specify the mappings and also can change the order of columns by dragging and dropping them. Moving to the open issues visualizations. This too uses the GitHub table. In the edit mode for the open issues dynamic, I see the timescale data source, one query, and then one transformation to have better titles for the plugins. The time series have relatively straightforward standard configuration. In this video, by the way, I talk about the Grafana time series in great detail. The link in the description box below. This visualization displays a snapshot of open issues. It uses the timescale data source, which is one query returning the plugin name and the latest open issue number. Then in the transformation filter data by value, I ask to keep only records with a positive number of open issues. In the second transformation, sort by, I order plugins according to the actual number of open issues, starting with greatest to the smallest. So here I see that the business table has most of our open issues. The business table draws a lot of community attention, which is fantastic news for us. Keep using it and tell us what can be improved. The last panel to cover today is business forms. For a better user experience, I keep it on a separate dashboard. When a new release is published, the release manager enters information about this event. We have four data elements to provide. The title is a plugin name with a version indication. The Grafana toolkit is a drop-down to select the latest supported Grafana version. The plugin is a drop-down to select one of our products. And in the description, user can add features details in HTML format. After clicking the Submit button, all data is transmitted into the database and immediately displayed right here using our business table panel. In the Edit mode, I have the timescale data source and then two queries. One is to prepare the listing to populate the Grafana toolkit dropdown, and query B to populate the plugin list dropdown. The business forms has a lot of parameters to configure. In the form elements category, I specify which visual elements I want to display. The title element has the string input type. The rest of the parameters are left by default. Grafana toolkit has the select with custom options type. And down here, I specify the column names of my data frame to populate the dropdowns for the user selection. The value field is what is going to be sent into the data source, and the label field is what the user sees on UI. The same goes for the plugin element. It has the select with custom options type and then data frame columns. The value field I instruct to take from the B data frame column ID, and the label field is to take from the B data frame column title. I keep the initial request section with the default setting because the business form does not need to execute anything on the load. In the update request, I say to use data source, specify timescale here, and then in the update request payload, I specify the query to update my data source data. Here I insert release information data elements into the release table. For more details about the configuration of the business forms, please refer to the official documentation on volkoflabs.io. We explain the data flow and all available form element types. There are plenty of different types to choose from. We also provide code snippets, examples, and many other things. This sums up the description of our release project. Now you know how we configured Grafana to make this project possible. You know which plugins we used, and most importantly, how to configure any Grafana visual plugin in general. Any questions, leave them in the comments below. That is all for now. Thank you for watching and see you next time.